In today's tutorial, we're going to be talking about the different forms you can create and the lead generation sources and how to create them. So let's log in and I'll see you there.
All right, now that we're logged in, let's head over to the lead gen tab over here. And we have a lot of different options. Some we've already talked about in the Web Assistant tutorial, but we're going to go into more detail here. So we're going to have the lead sources that we can choose. So we can create forms for marketing automation. So we can choose to create forms that will pop up on a website or show up on a website if we take the HTML code and insert it into the web page. The user who uses that form will go automatically into marketing automation and we can track them as such. So we can create forms, we can create events, we can create webinars, we can add existing leads, and we can add on-spot forms. So these are different applications of the same thing. We won't dive into every one of these because they're very similar once you get used to one of them. So we're going to show you what it looks like when you use the forms. And if you're looking to do events or webinars, you can create your own signup form for it. And that gets really handy as well because you can have a lot more information on these and they'll go straight into marketing automation and under the list that you chose them to go under. So you can create a new list that says event 2020 or event 2021, whatever it may be. And you can have leads go into that mailing list so that you can send out important updates. And maybe after the event or the webinar, you can send out slides or other value and maybe even a coupon code to try and get them to come and engage with your services. So that is one option there, but we're just going to go about showing forms and what that looks like. So we can create a signup form here. So we're just going to do that now. So we have the option to choose a live form already on our website. So we can hook into that. We can create our own signup form, or we want to choose to build a form through one of the other apps that is out there. So this is third-party integrations like Zoho Forms, Formstack, Drop Forms, or Rope. So these are all other tools that have been integrated into marketing automation to be able to use it in a bigger way so that that information gets pulled into marketing automation if you're already using those tools so you don't have to switch over. Now we have the ability to create our own form here, so we're going to click that. But I do want to quickly show you what it looks like when we select a form that's already on our page. So we do have the ability to go ahead and connect to a live form that's already on our website. We can select this form right now. So we just have to put in a name. So let's just call this a Clientric test. And then it does make sure that we select a form. So in this case, we're getting an error and I'm not 100% sure why. This is where I'd reach out to Zoho support to figure out what's going on, but I would select it and then proceed. But now I'm getting an error over here saying, please select a form. But anyways, I just want to showcase, this is how you'd go about it. Now I'm not sure if this is because I'm using Zoho sites and it can't pick something up in there. I'm not 100% sure what's going on, but this is how you'd go about doing it. So we're just going to cancel that. And we're going to go and create our own signup form. So now that we're here, we have the ability to create quite a few different forms. We have the compact vertical, we have the compact horizontal, long forms, and then we have standard pop-up and full page pop-ups, along with our library of saved templates. So right now we just have the compact vertical over here. We have the compact horizontal. We have the long forms over here, which is a lot more information and you can add in even more. Then we have the pop-up forms over here, which we can add and change. And then we have full page pop-ups as well. So there's a lot of options when you get in here. So I'm just gonna touch on a few of these. I'm just gonna go through the compact vertical very, very briefly, just so you can see what that looks like. So let's just say we wanna use this template. You come to this template builder. You can change the title here, say Clientric sign up. We want the email, we want the name. That's all good. We want to maybe change the body of this form. So we can say that the body we want, let's say to be 5 pixels. We can change the padding to be 5 pixels as well. So it makes it a little smaller. We can change the image settings. So we can say that we want position Y to be further up or down. We can change the size of it, change repeat. There's a bunch of options in here. I won't dive into too much detail because it's kind of, you just got to play around with that. So if we go to the heading, we can change the font even to Open Sans. We can change the size of the font. We can change where it's actually located, how it's justified. We can change the borders. There's padding over here to say that, let's say we want 14. On the form itself, we can change again, more bordering. We can change the padding. We got a lot of options there. And then same with the button. So we can always change this text in here. So we can say sign up. And then we have a border radius of 26. And we have our size here, which has a bunch of different properties we can utilize. And on the left here, we have the name field and what it actually maps to. So for example, we want this name to go into the last name field, the first name field. Because this isn't tracking both the first name and the last name, we can only have this go into one field. So it's going to map this name, whatever they type in here. So if I type in Casey Luft, it's going to be mapped exactly to the last name, which isn't maybe what you want. So you'd have to maybe go back and select a different form if you so chose. But in this case, we are just going to click save and proceed. And this gives us a few more options when it comes to actually using this signup form. So we can set up a signup thank you page, there's a confirmation page, and a resubscribe email. And so it looks like this is the single opt-in setting for marketing automation. I think if you have five options down here, that's going to mean that you're a double opt-in, which means that as soon as your user signs up, they send out an email to them and they have to click on that link to actually subscribe, and then they will be added to your lead list. So if that's not something you want, you'll have to contact Zoho support and get them to turn it off. They'll ask you some questions about why you want to turn it off and things like that. They want to make sure that you're not going to be continuing to spam people, because that obviously hurts their deliverability with the IPs that they use. So make sure that you go through this, you understand whether it's a single opt-in, double opt-in. If you're not familiar with either of those, make sure that you Google it and learn a bit more about it. But that is what happens when you have a double opt-in, and you can change that. You just have to get support to change it on the back end. So that is how you go about creating this, and you can set up these different thank you pages or redirect URLs. In our case, we're just gonna leave it as a thank you page, and I want to inline just send a message. So I wanna say, thank you for signing up. Now this means that basically they're just gonna have a pop-up that goes up on their webpage. It's gonna say, thanks for signing up. So it's not a new page, it's nothing new. It's just gonna pop up right there and look really nice. So we also have the ability to show a message here. Thank you for signing up for existing leads and for new leads. So we want that to be the same. We also want to go through the confirmation page. We can set this up as a thank you page or a redirect URL. Maybe you already have a URL that you want to send people to. That would be how you'd go about it. Then you can have a resubscribe email here, depending on whether or not they have unsubscribed from this list. So you also have that ability if they choose to unsubscribe and they want to resubscribe. So now let's save and get the code. So now saving, we see a bunch of options over here: website code, WordPress code, short URLs, buttons, raw HTML, no CSS, no script, Facebook page, and iframe codes. Now, generally what we do is we take this information. So we'll copy the website code, we'll copy the WordPress code, we'll give that to our client, and they will have their developer input it into the website the way they want. Sometimes we can go about just giving them the raw information here, what this code looks like, and they'll change it to be what they want it to be. You can update the CSS and the HTML and the JavaScript, whatever it is, to make it look a little bit nicer and more on brand. Over here, we don't have a ton of options. So if you do want more options, you can use this and update this code to make it look more branded to your website. So that's what I recommend there. And then we have a response setup. So this is what happens when your leads go through a submission. We have some automation tools here. So you can select a journey that they want to go in, or you can push this information as Zoho CRM. And then finally, we have reports, which allows you to track how many people come into this form and what they're actually doing when they get associated to this form. All right, now if we exit out of this, we can actually go back and create another form. And let's just go ahead and create this signup form. We can create a standard pop-up. We'll just use this template here. I'm not going to go into this in more detail, but we do have more options to edit and change this along the way. It's a bit more in depth than the previous vertical signup form template was. So we'll just go save and proceed. Again, you come back to this page here where it shows you your pop-up. You want to select what pages you want them to go onto. So you can actually select that here. So we could set, we want this to go to clientric.co if we so chose. But in this case, we don't want to, because I don't want this popping up on my website. But you can also associate them to a mailing list here. So you want them to go into a specific mailing list or one you already have. And then you're pretty much good to go. So you select this, and that's pretty much it. So you can set it to automatically pop up on your web page, and you can also select when you want it to pop up and go into more detail there as you get into that. So now that's how easy a pop-up signup form is. You really just have to go in here, select it, edit it, associate it to specific mailing lists, and then you can choose which pages you want it to pop up on, and then that happens automatically. And so you can choose activity-based criteria as well. If you want it to pop up, even you can use visitor type, devices, operating systems. We'll pull in all that information. You might even have different signup forms for people in different countries, depending on what information you're trying to gather. So there is a lot more settings there that you can explore when you assign a signup form to those pages when it's a pop-up. And that pretty much covers it for this tutorial. You now know how to use all of that. Events, we're not going to dive into. Webinars is basically the same thing. When you go through this, you can integrate different accounts. On spot, you can create. Adding leads, you can go through and just add them like we've done before. So again, I hope that's been helpful. Please make sure that you subscribe down below. We want to make sure that everyone who needs to hear this content, needs to see this content, is getting access to it. And by liking, commenting, and subscribing, you are letting us reach more people. And also be sure to subscribe to our Instagram and Facebook social accounts. We're building an awesome community and we can't wait to have you there. We look forward to seeing you in our next tutorial. Bye for now.